Hello and welcome to today's video break. We're in Psalm 33, 4, where it says, "For the word of the Lord is right and true. He is faithful in all he does." Nothing like the word of God, allowing it to be the foundation you and I stand on when we were seeking truth. There was, you know, it seems like there's been seasons where truth was, you know, not relevant, or your truth is your truth, my truth is my truth. I've even heard it said so many times, even the way you interpret the Bible can be so different. And I'm sitting here thinking that it isn't, God is so interested in our hearts that he designed, he created, he inspired, you know, all scripture is God breathed and it's useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness. And so allow the word of God to become the foundational place that you stand, to where it's, you're absorbed in it. It becomes how you make decisions and how you connect with God and how you can tell in the world when things aren't going right. It's not because of a feeling, but it's based on truth, because it's contrary to what God is speaking into. And if we understand that the word is actually the breath of God, that those words are still speaking today, that, you know, they're like a sword that can cut through the hardest places of our heart and, you know, bring relevance, bring truth, bring, you know, conviction. Allow that to become your daily source. And so I tell people, if you're not in the word of God, then you're in another word. You're allowing some other source to become the place, the sounding board in your life. And so when we allow God's word to become that place, we're standing firm. You know, nothing's going to move us, is what scripture says. And so David is making this command. So for the word of God is right, and it's true. He is faithful in all he does. And so now we just stand on God's word. I can't imagine saying, I'm going to take every day, God, I'm going to take you at your word. This is what you said. I'm not going to be swayed. I'm going to stand and wait on your promises. I'm going to stand and wait in your word. Because he's faithful. I found that a lot of people's words are not faithful and true. But you know, when we're standing in a place where we allow God's words to be faithful and true, we're in a good place. We're in a solid place. Allow God's word to be the place that you stand. Be blessed.